my students, welcome back to your online computer class. Today onwards we are starting our second term. Okay, so we can start our second term portions with fifth chapter, chapter 5, files and folders. We all are familiar with files, folders, and we are working with computer, we are creating files and folders, all that. So I think you all know what is files and what is folders. So, I will give an introduction about files and folders. We can take an example to understand what is files and folders. We can take an example from our daily life. You all have shelf, right? We can arrange our dress or books in shelf. If you think you are keeping books and clothes or book or clothes in a not a arranged or proper way. So, you can find one thing from that it's very difficult. So, what you want to do to find them quickly, you want to arrange them in a proper way in a separate shelf. Then you can find it each and everything very easily. Like that, in a computer, we can store all the information in a files or in an organized way or in a group of files. So that we can arrange all the group of files or similar types of files in a folder. Okay, so that is folder. And what is file? We can store all the information in a page, and all that is called file. Okay, so we can see what is files. A file is a collection of data that has been created, named and stored on a hard disk of a computer or an external storage media. You can create a file or you can keep some data, and you can name it and you can store it in a hard disk of your computer or you can store it in a storage medium. Okay, so there are many types of files you can create. You can create documents, image, spreadsheet, presentation or other information, any type you can create. We can see what are the parts of a file. If you want to create a file, then you want to save it, right? So, what we need? We want need a file name. If you want to save a file, you need to give the name to that file. Okay. And only the name we need? No. We need an extension. And we need a icon. File icon. We can see what all these. First, we can see what is file name. What is file name? If you are going to save a file and you give a name to that file, so that name is called file name. That file name will distinguish or identify what type of file or what is the name of that or what is the content of that file. The file name can be a combination of letters or numbers. Okay, you can give numbers or you can give letters to that file name. And then it is followed by, that file name will be followed by a period. Period means a dot. Okay. And an extension. Okay. So, what the full file name means, the name you given, and then you should give a dot, then give an extension. Okay. Then it will become a file name. Okay. This is file name. Then we can see what is file extension. File extension means it is set of character added to the end of the file name. Okay, after that dot or after that period, there will be a set of character. That is called extension. What is the use of that extension? It helps our Windows or the operating system to understand what kind of information is in that file and which program will be opened. So that is the use of that extension. Which program you want to open, or what is the information, what type of information that you are saving in that file, it's all that is known by that extension. Okay, we can see an example. myfile.txt. myfile means that is the name of a file, then we will follow it with a period or a dot, then extension. Extension is txt. Okay. Then txt is the extension, which means it is a text file. Okay. And a computer or the Windows will know it is a text file and we want to open a WordPad or notepad. Okay, we can see some of the text file extensions and programs. .txt means notepad. .docx. .docx means Word 2016. .xlsx means Excel 2016. Then .pptx. PowerPoint 2016. Next .mdb. Access 2016.avi, Windows Media Player. So with the extension, the Windows will know what type of program it is. That is the use of file name. Okay, next comes file icon. What is file icon? The file icon will represent that file of your computer. Okay, all the files in a computer have specific icons. In a computer, every computer having every specific icons. We can, by looking or by seeing that icon, we can find what type of file it is. Okay. For example, myself.txt. It is a notepad file. It will represent notepad sheet. So this is a notepad sheet, and this is the way the icon will be represented in your desktop. Okay, we can see the file icons and their associated programs and file type. First one is text file. Then associated program is notepad. Then document file. What is the icon? This is the document file icon. And our program will be Word 2016. Then spreadsheet. This is the spreadsheet icon. And associated program is Excel 2016. Presentation file. This is the file icon. The program is PowerPoint 2016. Then comes an audio file. This is MP3. This is the audio file icon, MP3. And the music symbol and MP3 is written below it. And the associated program is what? Windows Media Player. Okay. So, dear students, please go through this and folders and the subfolders, all that we can see in the next class. Okay, dear students, take care. Bye-bye. Thank you.